Hey guys, what's going on? It's Louie here, and today we've got a fantastic tutorial for you. I'm going to be showing you how to create a Tails Live USB with persistent storage in what I think is the easiest way possible. Tails is a privacy-focused Linux distro, and it helps you use the internet anonymously and avoid censorship. It's actually an operating system that I covered very briefly in a previous video, but without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Alright, before we start, there's a few things that we are going to need, so important. Firstly, so you can literally just type download Tails, Google it. It should be the first thing that comes up. I'll have this link in my description. This is the one right here. If you're really worried about privacy and security, make sure you verify the download yourself. This is kind of for educational purposes, so I'm not doing everything that you'd need to do to verify. Assuming you're on Windows, you'll hit this button. It'll give you some instructions. The main thing is you want to click this download button right here, and it'll start downloading the IMG file. Next, you're going to want to download a program called Rufus. This is going to allow you to create the bootable USB, and in my opinion, it's the easiest one. If you go to this website, I'll have the link in the description. Go ahead and click on that. It'll download it. And then lastly, you're going to need some sort of good partition manager. The default one that Windows has isn't the best, so I'd recommend just finding something. I'm using EaseUS. It's a little bit spammy in terms of them always begging you to get the pro version. But the free version will work just fine. You go to the free version, free download. It'll ask for an email address, and then you hit this button. It'll download it, and then you can go ahead and install it like normal. But once you've got all of those things installed, you're going to go ahead and open up your partition manager. So in my case, EaseUS. And once this loads, what we're going to do is format the USB as a FAT32 file system. This is so important. So just to kind of demonstrate, I'm going to go ahead and delete this. So unallocated. Create, and then change the file system to FAT32. Nothing else is really important. You're just going to go ahead and do that. Hit apply and let that do its thing. It shouldn't take too long. There we go. And once that's done, you're going to go ahead and open up Rufus. So you can go to your downloads, Rufus, right click, run as administrator, and then hit yes. Go ahead and close this out. Yeah, so spammy. Oh, please get the pro version. Anyway, you're going to go to list USB hard drives if you don't see your USB already, but most of the time it should be up there. I'm using kind of like an external USB with a lot more storage than normal, so it kind of detects it as an external hard drive. But anyway, make sure that you have the right one selected. Then you can browse for your ISO or your IMG file. Rest of this stuff you don't really need to mess with. You're just going to hit start. It'll go through, and this should take 5 to 10 minutes. Maybe not even, and once that's done, you're ready to boot into Tails. Alright. In my opinion, the easiest way now to boot into a live USB, if you go to reset this PC on Windows, you'll see an option that says Advanced Startup, and then you'll hit Restart Now, so this is ready. Once it says ready, you're good, you can just close. But to reboot into Tails, and then we're going to set up the persistent storage, you're going to go to Recovery, Advanced Startup, and then hit Restart Now. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to my phone's camera, and I will see you in a sec. All right, I am now on my phone, so I apologize in advance if the camera is a little bit shaky or the audio is not as good as it normally is. But once you do the advanced restart, this is the screen you'll get to. It says choose an option, and you're going to go to use a device, and you'll see all your hard drives, disks, everything will be right here. You want to select the one that you just installed Tails onto. So in my case, it's the UEFI OS. So I'm just going to go ahead and select that. And now what the computer is going to do is restart. Another way to do this on some PCs, when you reboot, you get a quick flash screen where it says like press F11 to access boot device list or press such and such to access boot device list. But otherwise, it should just go ahead and load like normal. You can see it brought up Tails and now it's booting up into the system. I'm going to show you a couple of potential errors. So I actually will probably get an error here. Because my USB is so large, it is technically considered an external hard drive. So after this sits and loads for a minute, I might get an error saying that it can't detect a live file system. So I'm going to show you how to work around that if you get that error. So I'm just going to wait for a second. All right. So as expected, I got the error, unable to find a medium containing a live file system. So on certain USBs, this is common, nothing to worry about. To work around it, you're going to go through these same steps again. So reboot your PC. You might have to go through that whole like reboot, advanced startup, and you're going to select the device again. But when it prompts you, you're going to select Tails from an external hard drive. So let's go ahead and wait for the PC to boot up. And yeah, I'm going to have to go ahead and go through this whole thing again. All right, so same deal as before. Oops, we're not going to troubleshoot. We're going to use the device.
UEFI OS, let the PC reboot, and you're gonna have to be kind of quick because the menu where it gives you the option to select Tails can time out relatively fast. So you can even kind of just spam like the down arrow key on your keyboard. But you can see if you have the option and you're getting the error, you should see something that says Tails external hard disk. You're gonna go ahead and select this instead. So click on that, should boot up like normal. Could take a little bit, especially if you have an older USB, so give it some time. And then once it's loaded, the actual setup for the persistent storage is extremely easy, so I'll show you how to do that. All right, so eventually you're gonna get to the Welcome to Tails screen, and you should see an option that says persistent storage. You're gonna go ahead and click Create Persistent Storage. The rest of these settings should be fine in most situations, but you're gonna go ahead and hit Start Tails. It'll do its thing. And it'll actually create the persistent storage entirely on its own. In my instance, and I'm just gonna skip that for now. So you're just gonna hit continue, create whatever password you want. So just for the sake of this tutorial, I'm gonna do 123. Such a fantastic password. Create persistent storage, and it'll do this all on its own. It'll create a partition. In my instance, because my flash drive is so large, it's 128 gigabytes. I have basically 128 gigabytes of persistent storage because Tails is so small. It's probably like 120 gigabytes minus the size of Tails. But let me let this finish and I'll show you what it looks like. And there we go. Now you can configure it in terms of like customization. If there's certain things you want to save, and you can also change the password. You can also delete it. But if I go ahead and go to my file explorer, you can see there is now a folder called persistent. If I right click on mine, properties, you can see I've got, it's actually 120 gigabytes. So I have 111 gigabytes of free persistent storage through this flash drive. And with persistent, again, that means stuff that will stay. So with Tails, like if I start browsing the internet, download some stuff, whatever, it is normally just gonna reset, like basically factory reset everything every time you restart. Persistent storage lets you save some things, so like if you have bookmarks, applications, that sort of thing, you don't have to reinstall them and redo a whole thing from scratch every time. So like I said, this I think is the easiest way to do it. It's the most straightforward. Let me know if you have any questions or run into any issues in the comments, and I'm always happy to help you troubleshoot. But that's going to do it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to drop a like, and I will see y'all next time.